Ekanene, nikisema kuwa David Ndii is a supporter of the Gen Z movement, unaweza semaje? Unaweza sema nimelipwa ama unaweza sema niko na point? Na before we get into that, wacha nibaki nimekuremind kuwa kuna vile the football season imerudi, na vile football season imerudi, of course kuna vile unaweza baki umebet like with the best betting company hapa Kenya, na hiyo ni linebet.com. Na ukibet na linebet.com na ubaki umetumia the promo code MWAF, MWAF, unaweza baki umejishindia vitu kadhaa. Kwa saizi, apart from ku get bonus, kuna vile unaweza baki umejishindia hoodies, unaweza baki umejishindia t-shirts, na pia unaweza baki umejishindia, unajua, macaps kadhaa. And the only thing una need kudu ni kuregister ukitumia the promo code MWAF. Alafu baki pia umetafuta the app ya Linebet, unaweza baki umeipata both kwa App Store na pia kwa Google Store. So za baki hiyo ni Play Store. Alafu pia una deposit like a minimum of 250 shillings only. Yes, minimum of 250 shillings only. Alafu vile umecheki jo, it's the cold season, kanjeve kanataka kurudi, so unabaki umestanda chance ya kujishindia vitu kadhaa. Na of course nitakubaki nimekusetia link yenyewe, but link yenyewe ni bonus, alafu yani Linebet alafu slash muaf. Ndabaki nimekusetia link hapo kwa description, baki umeingia hapo chap chap, alafu uone kama utabaki umejishindia the bonus. Na hiyo of course ni for the people walio na register for this first time. Tumia promo code muaf. Sasa wacha to go back to hizi story na politics. Kuna kitu fulani ile David Ndii alibaki amepost on Sunday, na vile umse aliposti story on Sunday, ndibaki nimechiki umse he's working for Gen Z, but a lot of us hatujui because politics inakuwaga emotional sana. So normally when someone says kitu hau agree nayo, we tend to go with the emotional side than kufikiria kuona. So kitu David Ndii alisema ni Gen Z challenged William Ruto to a political contest. William Ruto pulled the rug from under their feet and is on the ground consolidating his base village to be village. They're here trolling. Alafu 2027 they'll start Cherera nonsense. So, Gen Z challenged Ruto to a political contest. When the protests started, I always go back to June 18th. Zilianza juu David Ndii aliambia gawase kuwa digital activism is working. Na cheki, hiyo online activism, hiyo like mko pale mnazusha mnazusha. So when he said that, ndio wasoka jam, wasoka anza kuhipiana ni aje, tunizenda kwa ground. Alafu watu wakaenda kwa ground. So this is the guy that actually pushed people to go to the ground. This is the guy that ended up making the middle class waende kwa ground. Alafu the protests were different. So on the 18th, middle class walikuwa involved. On the 20th, middle class walikuwa involved. On the 25th, middle class walikuwa involved. Tao ilikuwa imejaa to levels that could not, no one could imagine. What happened on the 25th at night? Ruto alitokea kama jam, because for the first time Ruto felt threatened. And vilon unajuaga au semaga like if you corner an animal the animal will attack. So he was so angry he came out akatuita criminals, akatuita nini, akasema vitu zinaenda kubadilika. Then baadaye akaenda kamboja, buda jo, kuna vile inchi imebadilika, na vile inchi imebadilika itabidi ucheze chini ndio uone kunaendaje. Ndio the 26th akatokea akabaki amesema ame reject the finance bill. But sasa sisi kama Gen Z kulikuwa na ile kitu tulikuwa naita dopamine rush, we wanted more, so that's why kukakam na historia Occupy State House. But ukiangalia the original idea behind Occupy State House ilikuwa if Ruto does not reject the finance bill, tunafaa ku Occupy State House ndio tubaki tumemwona aki sign our life away. I remember that was the wording on the poster. But now that time vile tulishinda on the 25th, instead of relaxing and pulling back and what, people ended up wanting to do more and more and more. What happened? Ruto ended up reading the script, alafu akajua hii script, the easiest way kudeal na hii story of course ni kuandlish makarau on the citizens and make them use lethal force. So the violence that we saw on the 25th ilikuwa very little compared to 27th kwenda forward. Now the government became more violent. But sasa tukigo back to David Ndii, the reason why na feel kama David Ndii is helping Gen Z ni huu ndio msee alitu push tukaenda kwa streets. Alafu huu ndio msee upendaga kukupatia ukweli hata time hauifurahii, unabaki umejam umejam na yeye. Kama yeye kutuambia historia, tulichallenge msee to a political contest, and right now he's going everywhere solidifying his base. Anatrai kutuambia like, puda, anzeni kujipanga. 2027 iko hapa. Na kile nani katia na hii story ni kuna wasi wako unrealistic. Ile design nasema ile dopamine rush ya kuoccupy state house. Ya kuoccupy parliament. Kuna wasi wanafikiria that tuneza baki tumefanya Ruto atoke before 2027. Puda usikuwe mtoi. Usikuwe mtoi. Na hapa sasa ndo unapataka kuna wasi wako jua online wako jua muafu jua na tukosea heshima. Unatuitaje watoi. We ni mwoga. We tuachie. Hakuna. Hautaipata any day. Nimekuambia. Usiende state house. Budo kita kukipa state house, weenda. Sitatandikwa risasi, sito kwa tu hapa. Utatuita waoga, laki utatuita waoga. Hawezi compare. Then kuna wasata kuambia, Buda, kwanina sema hivo, kwanini Bangladesh walifanya different? Bangladesh have a unifying factor called religion. We don't have that. It's a more religious state. So, there's something different about religion, especially Islam. It pushes you to the next level. Like inakuwaga ile like, kama mbaya mbaya, kusata nikidedi, naenda, 1, 2, 3. Christianity inakuwaga 50-50. Nikidedi nina happen. So, that hiyo kitu ita happen. Hiyo umanga unexpected to assess kumoja wataamuka wa muweta katu na daddy to daddy wacha to understate house. Ita happen. The only way kutuwa Ruto is through the ballot. Na ndiyo mtuwe through the ballot, una need kuanza kuprepare right now. And that's what David Ndii is telling you. Alafu unapata, wasona kuambia zizi, wewe atoko unasema hivo, asisi tutoka hapa and we'll be there no matter what. So ile time, wasona sema we'll be there no matter what. Ilibidi, unauliza mse, who was the first person to say we'll be there no matter what? Kwa msa naitua Gabriel Oguda. Sa hizu kienda kwa post za Gabriel Oguda, you'll find that all he posts about ni football. Uni msa likuwaga political kabisa, but sikuizu kienda kwa nini yake, anapostu jia Arsenal, Everton, Premier League, I think like the first post zake zote. Why? Because Oguda kulikuwa na mfollow closely, unge notice he was never for good governance, better governance. He was a pro-Raila person. So shidake likuwa gani, is Raila happy. That's why like, badayo kila like he was the one anawafanya kazi opi wandai, una notice. So kuna tofauti ya watu wanataka a better Kenya na watu wanataka a specific person to be a leader. And this is where unanagamu tetega wase kama Kasmuel na tetea seka Boniface Mwangi. Because Boni specifically nimemjua for very long, yes. Na najua like the sort of person he is. At some point did he support Raila? Yes. But as soon as zile nilizilisha, nalikuwa na support Raila because according to him he thought Raila would be a better president than Ruto. But ilishi hapo, it was always about a better Kenya. So to go back to Oguda, Oguda kuna hii time amekuwa abducted. Alafu after he was abducted, akatokea akasema he was offered 500,000 shillings a month to tweet pro-government stuff. Right now he's working for Pio Wandayi. Pio Wandayi is a cabinet secretary. Is he still getting the 500,000? You see why the status story was ish-ish. Was he abducted? Yes, he was abducted. Was he offered 500? No, he was not. Otherwise, angechukua, kusikaha kuchukua yu pesa, na saiza na wakia the government, the same government he was criticizing, then, of course, he's foolish. But sasa tuki go back to history ya David Ndii, I feel like, I don't know nini litudanganya, but this happens to everyone, where you end up overrating yourself, and every time someone brings you back to reality, unenda pumechukia. So kicheki, kama historia ya vile Ndii aliandikia wasi kuambia that tulikuwa challenged to a political contest, watu wamekuwa kimtukana sana. And it goes back to ile kitu nilikuwa nasema, ile wasi wengi sana wamekuwa in denial wakifikiria that what has been happening, ama what was happening in June was not politics, that was politics. Being on the streets complaining about taxes is politics, because politics is something that it's the one that determines everything from freedom of expression, the politics. So iko nini is political in that way, the fact that freedom to kuna freedom of expression tunza bonga Joseph story, hiyo ni politics. Ina come to even the sort of internet tunatumia hapa, hiyo ni politics. Kuna countries where you can't even access YouTube. I don't think unaweza access YouTube kiwa China, kina Facebook, kuna WhatsApp China, you see. So the politics, so politics is everything. So every time vile tuliendaga kwa streets tukasema reject finance bill, hiyo ilikuwa political. But usisahau pia Kenya, on the other side, politics has been so demonized that people don't like calling anything politics, kuzina chukuliwaga weni nini. So hii time David Ndii anatuambia kuwa tulikuwa challenge to a political contest, alafu anasema 2027. Umse atrai kutuambia jo 2027 iko hapa, hamjaji organize. Mimi niko hapa on record nikisema the first thing that Ruto should do is fire David Ndii. Without David Ndii, the probability tungeenda kwa streets ni very low. He's the guy who pushed us. huu ndio msali tuambia tuna wank tukamua zi. Yenyewe si wank lakini si this time. Wacha tuishie kwa streets. So, ukipata mse kama huyu, bado yuko hapa naambia, like organize politically. Na every time wanakuambia organize politically, you the only thing you look at is how much unamchukia, alafu unaanza kumtukana. Hapo ndio inaleta shida. So, saizi uko na wasi, kila mtu anamtukana. Okay, let only hata nimepata hiyo tweet. So, usahau the first protest came out on 18th of July. That's the first time that the middle class came out. But on the 14th of yani 18th of June. On the 14th of June, David Ndial commented, "Politics is a contact sport. Digital activism is just wanking. Any jackass can kick down a barn, but it takes a good carpenter to build one." Unacheki. So hapo kuna kata na fan flani wa iko nina itua Mr. Kinyanta aliandikwa, "Wee dinywa na hiyo kitambi yako kubwa." So this was on the 14th of June. Then straight after, wasi wakasema jo, tupatane Tuesday. Halafu wasi wakapatana Tuesday. And it ended up being such a revolutionary process, ama a moment, ama such revolutionary moments that new leaders arose. Nacheki. And this is where Mufil Vibaya wasi wakisema kuwa Gen Z haina leaders, because the leaders are there. They don't even need to be chosen. There are people who've risen. The cream rises to the top. So the cream that has risen to the top, we have the Casmuels who've come out. We have even like on the first day, I think on the 18th, one of the images that really pushed people to come out was ile time Hanifa alikuwa na get arrested. And so these moments were very important. And these moments were showing us new politicians. But we've come to associate politics with everything that's bad. So now that's why everyone attack history ya like e-leadership. So vile David Ndia aliandika hii story, mimi mwenyewe kwa Twitter nilienda up nimesema the same thing, nikasema like kuna vile ukiambiwa say that we need to organize politically, people get offended. And what was funny about this was the fact that like as soon as niliandika hivyo, the Gen Z's, and this is the most educated like generation, walienda straight kwa matusi. Like, hakuna ile kurizon. So, inafanya inakuwa a very tricky time, because unashindwa, as we pray for a better Kenya, and as we like hope for a better Kenya, try and ask yourself this. If the most educated amongst us can only insult you for having a different opinion, what should the most uneducated do? And what I mean by that is, saizi tunataka tu, kuna wasika mimi, wale hopefully, na hope kuwa one day we are going to put the likes of Casmuel on the ground, and we are going to the Masitaruses. We are going to ask them, like, you know what, we want you to represent us in parliament. But as they represent us in parliament, they'll have to go on ground and try and convince someone that, you know what, someone from your tribe being a president is not enough. Someone from your tribe being a governor is not enough. Someone from your tribe being a CS is not enough. They need to do something to help you. If the most educated cannot hear that, how are the most illiterate supposed to hear that? So, hapo ndio tuko na shida. Unacheki, because ukigo through hapo, ilikuwa kwa funny, because I have fun with this. Unajua, normally it's just, you just have fun with it. And I think this is the same thing. Maybe this is the reason why I'm word my Andy, because Andy also has fun with it. Like, when you write something and unaiacha kidogo hivi alafu unaona people just losing their ish. So I remember mimi niliandika like 100%. So vile David Ndia alisema Gen Z challenge William Ruto to a political contest, mimi niandika 100%, and when you tell them that economics is political and we need to organize politically, they cry like babies. The Kenya education system is a joke though, because how people don't understand siasa mbaya, maisha mbaya is beyond me. Then kuna mse fulani anaitwa Mwangi 928 aliandika, "It's sad that our policies are dependent on politics. It should be the other way around. The constitution constitutes its policies should drive politics." And this is the interesting thing about it, because if you look at the word policy and you look at the word politics, they literally share letters, like a lot of letters. Politics will always dictate policy. What's the Kenyan government's policy against corruption? Is corruption is legal. And how has corruption been legalized by Kenyan politics? Politics dictates policy. If I was to use an example, alafu tunaishi kwa the age of information. So this is the information that you can go to. But if you are to go, uta notice in other countries they have right and they have left. Yes? Then they have far right and they have far left. So right, for example, in the US itakuwa Republicans. Left ni Democrats. Far left, and far right itakuwa the Republicans who don't want any immigration, who don't want any abortion, who don't want what. Far left itakuwa what they say, wanataka hizi story like LGBTQ rights, wanataka zikuwe top of the table where a man can wake up and just call himself a woman, we should treat him like unacheki. So hizo ni far, but the politics. So unacheki kama left, Obama ka legalize gay marriage, because that's left, that's Democrats. Right, Trump akaleta ama judges wote wa ma Republican, hao ndio kabaki wametoa story za abortion rights. Politics, policies, they go hand in hand. Good governance ni politics. What's a country? A country is a political entity, yes? And what end of the definition here? Country. Because kuna ni kwa chikiwa sana uliza like utasemaje hii kitu tuna need nini like politics, and this is where unachiki mataina blemigi like Kenya did education, because kuna kitu moja ile nani alisema kwa saja watch interview ya yangu na Casmwell alisema that problem ya education ya Kenya ilikuwa ina test your memory, like how much can you come up with, and how much can you remember, and that's nini. So kuna swali, is a nation a political entity? Iko kwa Google. Political entities include nation states, empires, kingdoms, city states, multinational states, multi what. Yes, so a state is specifically a political and a geopolitical entity, while a nation is a cultural and ethnic one. So can a country be called an entity? Yes, so na check it. So countries, politics is everything. Like politics is the reason why Africa iko vile iko hivi ni juu ya politics. Because politics zetu zinakuwa gani, we elect leaders and then we worship them. We never question them. So this is the reason why we've come to this level. And that's why we need to change our politics. And to change our politics, we'll need to change it through senators, legislators, yani nini, senators are legislators. We need to change it through MPs and senators, yes. And apart from that, we need people with a different mindset as governors. We need people with a different mindset as MCAs. So all these levels, we need to change. And the only way to do that is through political organization. And this is the reason why ukienda online, kama jana, utanotice kuwa wase kama kina Waititu, people who are starting to fall behind and disappear, so hizo washaanza kutia line. Unampata hapo kwa nyuma ya Kalonzo, wacheki. And so kuna wase wanasema kuwa vitu zimechange na sifai kuwa nabonga vile nabonga hivi. Vitu zimechange na vitu zimechange due to the protest, and Kenya will never be the same. But if Kenya will never be the same, would George Ruto have released the photo that was released? Because this photo, as I say, it depends when was it released. Was it released before the protests? Ama was it released after the protest? Was it released before the outrage? Ile people being angry at his matatus? Or was it released after people were angry at his matatus? Because hii photo, akiwa amesimama next to the matatu, holding a medal, and inaonyesha that he does not care about what Kenyans feel. Because remember, Kenyans were very outraged, were like, these people are playing by their own rules. And this attitude ya George Ruto is the same attitude tuliona na Oscar Sudi. When Oscar Sudi went on the Obina show, akabaki ameonyesha na watch ya 17 million. Na apart from kuonyesha na watch ya 17 million, akasema, I have two such watches. That comes to 34 million. What he was showing you is, we've already won this thing, and there is nothing that can happen. And another example ni, ulicheki majuzi, Murkomen alienda pame travel. And remember, when Murkomen was nominated again as a cabinet secretary, he actually released a tweet. And on the tweet, alienda pame, amesema kuwa, he was apologizing. He was saying that if he done anything that offends us, what is it called, like forgive him. And remember there was the infamous Twitter space, ile ilikuwa na umse anaitwa nani, the Twitter space ya Osama, ile the president came out and the president was like, I'm going to ask my people to show less opulence. And what did Murkomen do? When Murkomen was traveling to Paris for a trip that he was not needed, he ended up traveling and he had this small bag of his. Hii bag yake ni Bali. And the bag itself, very small, I think inatushana hivi. It goes for 461 pounds. 461 pounds, if you are to multiply that by around 160, that's a lot of money. I'm gonna check it. Because that one would have how much? That 46, that's 276, only 46 plus 28. That would come around to around 74,000 shillings. Yes, would come around to 74,000 shillings for a bag this small. I check it. So they're back to showing your level of opulence. Why? Because they feel that the president is winning. And why is the president winning? Because after what happened on the 25th, took a seat back. 27th, unleashed the military on us. Sindio. And apart from unleashing the military on us, of course, then we started seeing like unprecedented levels of violence. And what happened? The middle class, as usual, retreated and went back. So right now you have a few people who are in the front line. And nini wame retreat. So saizi, hata inasemekana kuwa umsaitwa Mbadi. Mbadi wants to release the same finance bill. He might bring it back. Do you think that people will come out for the protest like they came out before? No, people won't. And not because they are cowards, but because they know, number one, the amount of violence that happens. And number two, they know that the movement does not know when to stop and when to start. Because the movement does not have a leader. So it's like we'll just keep protesting. And people can't protest forever. People have other things to do. Najua, kuna mtu atakuwa out on the streets every day. And when you say these people are like, oh, zizi, umelipwa, ume, alafu yo pia ndio, like another thing ile inahappen saizi. Like, I really hate the fact that every different opinion is classified as mtu amelipwa. And I don't know where we are going with this. But saizi mikile nazasema ni gava ina win. Nah, the government is not winning cause of anything, but it's winning cause people don't even know that we're involved in a political fight. And in a political fight, you have to fight it politically. And you fight it politically through knowing that, number one, we have the numbers. So we have the numbers. The people who want change, we have the numbers. Do we have all the numbers? No. Because don't forget, tribal politics in Kenya stays. So it means with these numbers of ours, to lie to ourselves that we can get a leader from nowhere, that's a lie. And these are the things who can be ourselves on a co-offended. People get all up in their feelings. No, we have the numbers to back someone who is coming with a tribal backing and then just tilt it to their side, but then tell them that they need to do things differently. Acheki. They need to tell their tribesmen that someone being a CS from your tribe does not help you, like on a personal level. They need to be people who are going to fight corruption. But more than that, is it possible to get a new Gen Z leader? Yes, it's possible. And we can start, we can try, but we have to try right now. Na ukiambia wase hivo, wasona get offended, wasona kutukana, wasona tuko kwa hii process ile vile na shina nikisema, the most educated cannot take a different opinion. So how are the illiterates supposed to behave? How are the illiterates supposed to behave? Alafu apart from that, another thing ile na happen, saizi, hii me notice on X, is there's this guy who's doing a very good job, Morara. So Morara goes around showing like the fake projects that's happening. And ilekituina happen ni, as he does this, now some people always want to spoil. So kuna wase wameanzisha nini, wana post images that are not true. And these images just go. So there's this image of a woman. I think this woman was met by the president. Was it in Embu? So Ali was met either in Embu or Kisi. But someone has convinced people that the same woman was met in both Embu and Kisi. And people are believing this, people are posting this, people are reposting this. And this is what you know, like, when you do that, you do not help the movement. Even another thing that's going around ni wasewa mekua, wakipost hizi picture, ama videos, that is, where you hear maybe one person shouting something negative towards the president, and then watu wako like, oh, the ground is hostile to the president. No, the ground is not hostile to the president. The president is still loved in his tribal strongholds. Like, tribal politics won't end in a day. That's never going to end. And so when people post that the president is being booed, a lot of you believe, and someone else tells you, no, that's not the reality. Kuna kitu moja ile mpenda kubanga juu yake inaitwa confirmation bias. And this happens to everyone. Confirmation bias is, if you believe in something, you'll always look for evidence to back that up. And that's the reason why religion is big. Because religion is big because of this. Like, let's say umeamka asubuhi, alafu umeomba. After uombe, uende hapo chini, upate umenini. Utembee chini, wangukia 100 shillings. Nuko meambia, God, like, give me 100 shillings. What's going to happen? It's going to be like the prayer made me get that. Unacheki. But ukiomba nothing happens, utakuwa like, you still have to confirm. Haijalishi. He's still testing me. I'll get it the next day. Confirmation bias. Remember, watu wanachukia president. We mwenyewe unachukia president. So ukienda online, you watch any video and you feel like the crowd was a little bit hostile, you'll confirm to yourself that the crowd is hostile. And also, another thing is vile nashinda nikisema, politics ni so emotional that when someone tells you a contrary opinion, it's hard for you to believe that the opinion is just contrary. It has nothing to do with them respecting you or not respecting you. Since una nini, unaku offended, alafu unaku hizo stories, umsana nichukia, umsana nini. Defeating Ruto is going to be one of the hardest things ever. Umse alishinda Uhuru, time Uhuru alikuwa na ana fight. Uhuru was fighting against this guy, and somehow this guy was able to defeat Uhuru. For us to lie to ourselves that we are going to remove this guy in the first term without organizing politically, without like doing umse wanataka kurudisha the finance bill. Do you know how arrogant it is to even think of bringing back the finance bill? But right now they know that Wamelan, from the likes of Gabriel Oguda, they've learned that a lot of Kenyans stand for nothing. And the fact that we stand for nothing, this is the same reason why when you tell people we need a leader, they're like, our leader will be compromised. If that leader can be compromised, then that leader was not a leader in the first place. Why? Because to get a place come on. Senegal, for example. Senegal, there was the new president wa Senegal. Na u new president wa Senegal, alikuwa nakuja na beste yake. Beste yake anaitwa Sonko. So, the new president anaitwa Diomaye Faye. Diomaye Faye was arrested and stayed in jail for close to a year. Do you think that they did not try to compromise him? They tried to compromise him, but he did not get compromised. If the leaders that we choose can be compromised, then they are not true leaders. They were not true leaders in the first nini. People fight these temptations. So what are we talking about? If you're saying that atachagua mtu because atakuwa compromised. Acheki. So kuna kwa na hiyo shida. But I think nikimalizia, wacha ni check some of the nini niliona. It was so interesting to just see easy like nini. So there was that one where someone says that we are not supposed to depend on politicians. Then kulikuwa na Kihiko for real aliniambia wewe ni fala. Then kuna msana jita jailbird alikuwa anasema organizing politically to you means forming a party and having leaders. That's where you go wrong. Mr. Activism against the police brutality belongs to me because I started time ya Kibaki. Alafu kuna msaka niambia, are you ready to get exported? You are here no matter what. Then Msiflani itajaloka alisema something interesting. Alisema leaderless, formless and tribeless battalion will be assigned to shortly to with a sack full of insults. So people have predicted, like, that's what happens right now. The Gen Z, so-called Gen Z, not everyone of course, because majority of us who watch Ikonini Gen Zs and they don't kuwagi watu wa insults, but nizasema on X, the so-called leaders were Gen Z. Because on X pia, another thing that I noticed is kuna wase unapanda, they have a lot of followers, and now when you choose other people as the leaders and you don't choose them, they get offended. So kuna hiyo aspect lina understand. So I think hiyo ndio kitu moja imehappen na X played a really big role ikikam to like making Kenyans involved na hizi protest. But now with the same thing, egos come on board. So with the egos is, why are you choosing Osama Otero instead of me? Why are you choosing blah 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 instead of me? Why are you choosing? So kuna kwa na hiyo, that's why wasawa X wanakuwa offended and offended na nini. So so kuna mse moja aliniambia, so you register party kama uko na haraka, no one said we don't want a political party, we said it'll happen organically. That's interesting, a political party happening organically. Has it ever happened? Not in the history of mankind. So kuna mse alikuwa anasema, why are you in a hurry? That will happen. You're too eager for a change, but instead of supporting what's happening in the moment, you choose to stay on the sidelines with negative commentary of ngefanya. But we understand there was a trip to the US on a chartered Arab jet. Damn, okay. Yuzaje. Then the same person aga continue, the primary thing is not a political party in the current agitation. That may have been true for the previous agitations. You don't primarily need a political party to demand economic liberation through progressive politics, because we already have political freedoms. This is interesting. You don't primarily... Okay. This is an economic freedom action. There's literally a party called Economic Freedom something in South Africa. Okay. Maybe I'm wrong. But yeah, so this is what we are dealing with. Tuna deal na wase wale wana jam kabisa ukiwaambia kuwa to fight Ruto, you're going to have to fight it politically. Na tuna deal na wase wale in their mind, they believe Ruto is going to resign before 2027. And this is why I think wase wakisema niko condescending. This is why I understand I'm condescending. Because I actually believe, if you believe that Ruto is going to resign before 2027, you need to get your head checked. That's not going to happen. African leaders don't resign. When's the last time an African leader resigned? You know, you have to use history as a stepping up. You know, like, African leaders don't do that, yeah? Mse kama Bashir had to be pulled down. And you have to look at, when you look at the Arab Spring, you have to look at the common element in all this is Islam. Not Christian nations. Christian nations, it's either a military coup ama kitu ingine, but it never happens. Miwaga anti-military coups kabisa. So I'm happy personally with the Ruto presidency till 2027. I hope that another political movement is going to form so that he ends up being a one-term president. But do I think that's going to happen? No, I don't think that's going to happen. Am I going to be called compromise? Yes, I'm going to be called compromise, because people want you to tell them what they want to hear. They want you to tell them that economics is not politics. This is all political. Majuzi umsenaitwa Mudavadi came out and said Kenya loses 608 billion annually. Scare you. 608 annually billion to corruption. Do you think during Magufuli's time anyone would have said that? Yes. During Magufuli, this would have happened. Remember when I said everything is political, Ikonini would not exist under Magufuli unless naifanya nikiwa outside Kenya. So if I was a Magufulian, I'm a Tanzanian, that is, Magufuli comes on board, for me to do Ikonini, I'd have to do it from far. So ile time nile hapa US, ngesika asylum, nitrai kuishi huko. But one thing I'm 100% sure, during Magufuli's time, ungesikia Tanzania nakisema 608 billion. Even Tanzanian shillings. Because 608 Tanzanian billion Tanzanian shillings would be 30 billion Kenyan shillings. That would never get lost under Magufuli. So everything that we deal with is political. And that means everything tuna deal nayo, and I need political solutions. And I really hope that we are going to reach a level where we can have a discussion without insulting each other. Najua, like, we ni umbwa, we ni fala, umelipwa, we are educated. I don't know. It's a very sad state of affairs that we can't have that discussion. But yeah, as I usually say, kama we ni mse, you think you can argue out stuff without kuni-insult, ama kuinsult watu. Yeah, I'm always open to have that discussion. I want someone to come and show me how they feel in less than a year. of organization tunaweza baki tumeshinda route. I'd want to see how that mathematics works. Because for me, I know it's going to take much, much more. It's going to take a lot of organizing. And this is something that Komenda mkawatch interview yangu ile nilifanya na Eugene Wamalwa. I remember I also asked him, like, is it possible to defeat Ruto if by now they don't even know who's going to run against Ruto? I'm very consistent when it comes to that. It's not going to be easy to defeat this guy. To the Kenyans on X, I really, really hope one day you'll reach a level where you don't treat everyone as an enemy. You don't treat everyone as someone who's been compromised. And you can sometimes look at the people who are you're on the same side with and just see, like, you know what? This person is on our side. The only thing they're saying is we need to put in more effort, you know, because you need to put in more effort. Nothing comes easy. Nothing comes easy. That's why, because like one of the things nakuwa kuna msemo mmoja alikuwa ananiambia ushaanza madharau tutabaki tumeunsubscribe, niko like buda jo tulianzaga hiki kitu kitambo na tukianzisha tuko tunaambia wasi like kama ufurahi opinion kuna place inaitwa Kajitombe. So si kiburi, nilitukuambia like if you can't handle a different opinion, like una planaje kusurvive in a democracy? Ile msana kuambia like hey, buda jo najua najua na try, lakini can we do more, can we do more, si kwenda so ndio kitu ina happen. But yeah, so that's it. Wacha George Ruto aendele kuenjoy matri zake. Wacha Kip Murkomen aendele kuwear his expensive watches, expensive bags. Okay, of course, Raila na ODM betrayed the country. And now the greatest fear comes. If they bring back the finance bill, what will we be able to do about it? Because the amount of violence they are going to use to make sure it passes through is a lot. But there is no leader to challenge this guy in 2027. What's going to happen? I guess we'll have to wait for it to happen organically. Ekonene.